Now, if you're an absolute beginner to Adobe Illustrator, this is a tutorial for you. I'm just going to take you through the very, very fundamentals of the program. I've just clicked on the Adobe Illustrator icon, which will look like this somewhere on your desktop. By the way, this is Adobe Illustrator CS4 that I'm working with. And this is the first dialog box that you'll see. And this in itself is actually quite confusing, really, because you'll see it says create new and then it says print document. And people think, well, I don't want to print my document yet. I want to, I want to create a new one. And I do think this shouldn't say print document, really. I think that's a bad choice. I think it should say, create a new document for printing. but that's exactly what it means. It means create a document that you intend to print later on. That's got, the right resolution for printing, okay? So this is the one that you usually work with to start with. And by the way, these down here are just, last files that either you or somebody else who was on the computer work with. So you can just jump to a previous file if you want to. So I'm going to create a brand new document for printing. So here we go. Print document is what we want. So I just click on there, and the first thing that comes up is pretty obvious, really. It needs a size. A4 is a good sort of starting point. Often it doesn't really matter about the size, because things will be exported to other programs. But forget about that for now. A4 is a fine size, and the number of artboards for the moment we're leaving it as 1, so let's not make things complicated. So just click OK. Oh, by the way, you can name the document here if you wish. We should do that now, of course, and just click OK. Right, so here is a blank Illustrator document. This is the first thing that you will see. I'll just move this around a bit so it's a bit better for this screen recording. Okay, right. Now then, lots of tools here to play with, but I'm just going to take you through the very fundamental things just to get you started. First thing, if you look at window here, you will see the certain ticks. These are windows that are already opened. You may not be able to see the brushes. There they are. They were already open. Okay, so I'm just going to close these windows just to start with, and then it makes it clear a few. So, window. Now, the main thing, this is for floating palettes, palettes that you're going to need while you're working. Now, you wouldn't have every palette tick, because then you wouldn't be able to see, you wouldn't be able to see your blank screen. You will always need the tools. You will always need the application bar and the control bar. That's these things here that you can see. So, they're kind of default. One thing you might want to have up straight away, really, is swatches. And just tick that. And here, these are colours. So we'll deal with this bit first, and then we'll see what other palettes we can possibly use that are in there. Okay, now then, we need to just create an object, and there are multitude of ways to create objects in this program. You can use a pen tool, you can use these things here in the line tool, you can use a brush, or you can use some default shapes. There are lots of different ways. So we're just going to make it simple. By the way, did you notice that some of these tools here have a little triangular black arrow in the corner there, a black symbol? And it just simply means that there's something else in that toolbox. And if you just hold the mouse down, then you can see that there are other things in some of the toolboxes. Not all of them. See, that one's just you know, just got the one tool, but there are others way down here that have got lots of different things in the same toolbox. Here we've got a nice selection of kind of default shapes. So I hold the mouse down there and I can see that you can choose, if you wish, a rectangle, a star, a polygon or whatever. If you want to leave this toolbox open, you see, if you let the mouse go, it'll just disappear. But if you want to have this open, it has this wonderful feature called tear off menus, tear off. So if you just kind of just move the mouse to this little tiny arrow there and then just let the mouse go, it will tear the menu off. So it's kind of open all the time, which is can be handy sometimes. Right, so from these, it's pretty obvious that you can create some default shapes. So here's a rectangle. There. Here's a star. And here's a circle. Okay. Now, once an object is drawn, you will nearly always need to use this tool here, which is a selection tool, just the normal black arrow selection tool. Okay, this means you can select the objects and you can actually just move them. You can resize them. And that's about really all that you can do with the black arrow. It's just for resizing and selecting objects. Can you see I can click on one object and select that and move it around? Or I could click on all three objects here by just dragging the mouse around them and then dragging them, and they kind of move as a group. They're not really a group, they're not grouped together, because as soon as you click off again, they will become individual again. But it's handy if you want to move a group of objects quickly, you can do that and use the black arrow to do that. Now, at the moment, these objects have a black stroke and a white fill. We talk about fill and strokes in a vector program. So the stroke is the, you know, the line around the object, and the fill is obviously the fill color. Now the fill color of this star at the moment is white. Yeah, as you can see here, it's telling us the fill is white and the stroke is black. This is the kind of default colors that will come up. So if we want to change the colour of this star, the fill, then we just make sure it's selected, go to the swatches and give it a different colour. Yeah, you can leave it selected and try different colours till you're happy with what you've got, and then that's easy enough to change. Okay, same with the other objects. Make sure the object is selected and fill that. And this object here, fill that. So that's fairly easy to understand. Now you'll notice that when you click on the object, it shows you the colours here that you've got. Okay, there you go. See, it changed for each colour, for each object. Right, now what about the stroke? Well, the stroke, as I say, is the line around the object. At the moment, this is just a thin black stroke. So select the object, look at the top here, and this is a 1-point stroke. So let's make it a bit thicker. Let's make it 4. Let's make it even more than that. We'll make it 6. There we go. So we can change the actual, you know, the point size of the stroke and the colour of the stroke. So how do you change the colour of the stroke? Because, as you know, when you click on here, you just change the fill. Well, it's all to do with these two things here. This, as I said, is the stroke. So if you bring this thing to the front of this by just simply clicking on it like that, now it's at the front. Anything that you click on here now will apply to the stroke. While that's at the front, you are dealing with strokes. So there's a green stroke, there's a purple stroke, and so on. Okay, so we can easily change any stroke like that. So you can kind of, you know, alternate between these two here. If I want to change the fill again, I bring the fill to the front, and now we'll give it a blue fill. Okay, if I want to change the stroke, bring the stroke to the front, and now that's a green, horrible green. So let's make it something a bit more useful. There we are. So that's how you change fill and strokes, by doing that. And by the way, if you want to, you know, reverse this, for instance, have a blue stroke and an orange fill, then this little thing here will sort of alternate between them. Yeah, so you can, you know, you can change objects that way as well. If you want to default back to normal sort of black and white, then there's a default fill and stroke thing there, which will just bring everything back to 1 point stroke black with a white fill. Okay, so that's pretty simple. Let's just, I'll just change that now. There's a quick way to actually bring these things to the front of each other, because it can be a bit cumbersome at times. You see, I've just made that accidentally into a white stroke, so I'll just do that. So it's now a purple stroke at 5 points. Okay, so a quick way to change these over, if you like, it's just a bit cumbersome sometimes moving backwards and forwards between here and there. If you just press X on your keyboard, that's the X key. Watch what happens when I press the X here now. The fill comes to the front, and if I press the X again, the stroke comes to the front. So you can alternate very quickly between those objects. So for instance, I click on here, I change it to green, and now I want to change the stroke, so I just click my X key and make the stroke red. And if I just make that a bit thicker, you'll see that it really did work. There we are. Okay, so that's you know, the fundamental starting point of the program. If you just play with these little default shapes and just try the different colours. Oh, and by the way, can you notice that the objects have a hierarchy as well? Now, the hierarchy being the first object that you created is at the back, then the next object is always in front of that, and the next object is always in front of that. As you can see, no matter where you move it, they will have this hierarchy. But of course, if you want to bring, say, this star to the front, then you go to Object, make sure it's selected first, then go to Object, Arrange, and Bring to Front. And now this is the frontmost object. Okay, if I click on it again, I can go Object, Arrange, Send to Back, which will make it the backmost object. And so you can build up designs in that way. I'll bring it to the front again, arrange, bring to front, and there you are. So you can arrange things like logos and design using the bring to front, send to back, and the color coloring idea using these tools here. So that should get you started. So have a go at that.